Hey everybody, it's Michael from INFINIT Nutrition, and we've all heard the buzz about high-carb fueling with fructose. And I sat down last week with one of my favorite, and by the way, very fast, dietitians, Leah, to get the scoop.
The evolution of carbohydrate has been really, really interesting. When I was racing in the 90s, 60 grams was kind of the number, about 250 calories, that was sort of max. Then there was a study that came out on the oxidization rate of carbohydrate when INFINIT was started, and that was how all of our science was based off of that, and that was blending maltodextrin, glucose, and sucrose. And so that blend of carbohydrate took the absorption rates from about 0.9 grams to 1.24, so about a 30% increase in calories, and that was huge at the time. And then about 5 years ago, we heard a lot of rumbling coming out of Australia, where they were pumping fructose and adding fructose to the mix as an additional pathway to get absorption rates. We're going from 80 now to 100 to 120 grams of carbohydrate utilizing maltodextrin and fructose. INFINIT actually has been working with 90 and 100 gram mixes in Australia, down in INFINIT Australia, and they've been hugely successful. And now the rage is everybody's talking 90 grams or 100 grams. And that's the evolution of carbohydrate, where we started in a place where we thought max was 250 calories. We're up at close to 500 calories in some cases now. We've been a part of that, and we're now bringing that to the United States.
Yeah, absolutely. It's awesome. And we have infinitely athletes like Trevor Foley, who's been pushing that 120. And so it's really cool to be able to, you know, hear his experience, hear his success with it. And he's super excited about this new product coming out because it is what he's doing right now already, just on his own. So we're able to kind of provide him with that ready to go fuel that he'll be able to use and hit those marks that he needs to push his 300 plus wattage that he's doing. The Tour de France athletes, you know, they're the ones that are pushing this limit and they're seeing a lot of success with it. So seeing us be able to put this product on the shelf and provide it for these elite athletes is huge because, you know, they're able to get in what they need. They don't need the same as an age group athlete who's pushing about 150. They're pushing 300 plus watts. So that's whole INFINIT's backbone is, you know, and custom nutrition. So based on what they need, and we're not providing that for the age group athlete and the elite athlete in the same way.
No, and it's a really interesting thing is that the age groupers hear what the pros do. Pros are pushing 350 watts. Age groupers are pushing 150 watts. Their energy needs are completely different. So don't do what the pros do. Do what's good for you. The other issue that you run into with a high fructose mix is the sweetness level. And it's sweet. There's no way around it. There's a couple of ways to reduce sweetness, and we do that with using sodium chloride, which is salt. And the way to tone down sweetness is with put a bunch of salt in there, which we do. But it's definitely sweet. So not only do you have to get used to that amount of calories, and you know, it's a half a cup of sugar is what we're talking about. It's a lot. But not only that, you got to get used to the sweetness. And so some people can't. I don't think I could use it in an Ironman. I think it's just, it would be too sweet personally for me. But having said that, if it does work for you, then it works.
Taking a deep dive into the science behind, you know, when we're ingesting carbohydrates, so we're on the bike taking in this blend, our glucose and fructose are using two different transporters. So glucose is coming through SGLT1 and fructose is coming through GLUT5. So that's how we're able to actually absorb these two different carbohydrates in a higher absorption rate, because you're not overloading one of the transporters. So by including this use of the other transporter, you're actually able to reach that higher amount of carbohydrates that you're ingesting without them just going to waste or not being utilized at all.
So with the increase in calories, with the increase in apparent, it appears eight percent performance?
8 to 9% performance bump for these elite athletes that are able to capitalize on.
That's incredible.
That, yep.
I mean, that's a really big number. So you're an athlete, you're a runner, an elite runner. how would you start down the path of going high carb?
You know, it's all about really training your gut. You have to build up your tolerance. So this is a big jump in calories for a lot of people that aren't used to doing this hefty amount. So, you know, you try it out before race day. Do not go into race day thinking that this is going to bump your performance by 8 to 9%. You need to train your gut. You need to build up your tolerance. And you need to start that doing that in practice multiple times, doing it in your hard workouts that are like races, getting used to that amount and seeing what works for you. And maybe that is 120, maybe that's a 90. Or maybe it just isn't at all, you know, it's a practice makes perfect kind of thing. And this is no different
Yeah. So one thing, you can try it out yourself. The other thing you can always do is schedule a consult with an Infinite Nutritionist where we're going to sit down, talk you through the process and take care of it. And just hit us up with an email if you guys have any questions at all.